Hello and welcome to our carol service for 2020. It's lovely that you can join us for our online service. My name is Reverend Chris Hutton and I'm the rector here for the Earsham Benefice, serving six beautiful villages in South Norfolk. Well, today we have our carol service, we have our traditional readings, and we have some traditional carols. Now, as we count down to Christmas, we have lit three of our Advent candles. Last Sunday, we lit the candle of love, and before that, the candle of hope and peace, as we remember Jesus, born in Bethlehem, come to fulfill all of God's promises and bring us everlasting peace and joy. Well, today we light the fourth candle, the candle of joy. When the angel Gabriel told Mary that a special child would be born to her, she was filled with joy. She sang a song that began with the words, "My soul magnifies the Lord, my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour." Just as the birth of Jesus gave great joy to his mother, so his presence in the world gave great joy to those who have none before. He healed them and gave them hope and peace. And when they believed in him, from hope, peace and love grows joy. We light the candle of joy to remind us that when Jesus is born in us, we have joy, and that through him, there'll be everlasting joy in earth. Joy is a light shining in dark places. As we look at these candles, we celebrate the joy that we find in Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Thank you, God, for the joy you give us. We ask that as we wait for all your promises to come true and for Christ to come again, that you would remain present with us. Help us today and every day to worship you, to hear your words, and to do your will by sharing your joy with others. We ask in the name of the one who was born in Bethlehem. Amen. And as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And we have our first Christmas reading from Isaiah chapter 9.
The reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, 6 and 7. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. This is the word of the Lord.
But our first carol is a great classic, Once in Royal David's City. So let us sing together.
Stood up. His cradle was a stall, with a poor and mean and lowly lived on earth our Savior holy. And our eyes at last shall see so dear and gentle is our Lord in heaven above, and He leads His children on to the place where He is gone.
We now have our second reading, the angel Gabriel appearing to Mary.
In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favoured, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at these words and wondered what kind of greetings this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favour with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be, Mary?" asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
We've just heard about how Mary will have a baby, and so let us sing our next carol, "Infant Holy, Infant Lowly."
Babies, Lord of all.
Often the innkeeper is left out of the Christmas readings, and so this year we're going to have a poem called The Innkeeper of Bethlehem. Over to Jill, who will read it for us.
The Innkeeper of Bethlehem by Marion Swinger. There's no room at the inn, he told them. We're full up, I'm sorry to say. Inn's crammed with people. Can't help it. I'm having to turn folk away. But there was something about the young woman. And the innkeeper shouted, Wait! I suppose you could sleep in the stable. There's nothing else left, and it's late. He showed them both round to the stable and settled them down for the night. Then he left, glancing up at the heavens, where a star shone unnaturally bright, gilding his face with a splendour that no one on earth ever saw as he entered his inn, slightly dazzled, quietly closing the door.
Well, our next carol is another great Christmas classic, O Little Town of Bethlehem. Let us stand and sing.
Above thy deep and dreamless
Well, what a great carol. Well, we now come to our main event, Matthew chapter 1, the birth of Jesus.
This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their marriage until she gave birth to a son and gave him the name Jesus.
Well, thank you for reading. This next carol, I think, is my favourite carol in the bleak midwinter. I just love the idea of giving our heart to God. Let us stand to sing.
I
And so as we follow the Christmas story, we come to our fourth reading, The Shepherds Go to the Manger, from Luke chapter 2.
The reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 16. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. This is the word of the Lord.
Now, we've just sung some wonderful carols, but what do the next three songs have in common?
And Rolly too, Lofty and Wendy join the crew. Bob and the gang have so much fun, working together they get the job done. Bob the Builder, can we fix it? Bob the Builder, yes we can.
That was Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody from 1975, Mistletoe and Wine from 1988, and Bob the Builder, Can You Fix It? From the year 2000. But they've all been Christmas number one. Now each year there's a lot of interest in who will be the Christmas number one in the charts. Whether it's the latest X Factor act from the TV or a campaign from Facebook that has pushed some other song to the top of the charts. This year it's a fight between Mariah Carey, the NHS Choir, or Lad Baby, the comedic pop act from TikTok. If you've never heard of him, don't worry, but he was Christmas number one last year as well. Well, the list of Christmas number ones, if you look at the list, is actually a bit odd. Some of the songs do have something to do with Christmas. Mistletoe and Wine, Chicken Stevens, Merry Christmas Everyone, or Band-Aids, Do They Know It's Christmas? But some previous Christmas number ones have nothing to do with Christmas. Mr. Blobby by Mr. Blobby, Two Becomes One by the Spice Girls, or Jimmy Osborne's Long Haired Lover from Liverpool. Well, for a moment or two, we're going to look at that very first Christmas number one. It wasn't on the radio, but it did come across the airwaves as the angels sang above the sky in Bethlehem, the original number one on the evening that Jesus was born. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests. Now the first line of the song is all about giving God glory to God in the highest, the fullest measure, the highest height, to the extent that he deserves it. Glory to God, giving God the praise that he is due because of what he has done. Now if someone has done a good job, it is right to praise you. And what is it that God has done that he deserves that praise from the angels? We get a hint in the second line. The angels give glory to God because he is giving to us peace to his people on whom his favour rests. God's favour, his grace, is our undeserved gift at Christmas time, given freely. Even though we're at war with God and with one another, if not openly, in our hearts, God still gives us his gift of peace. Peace with him, peace with one another. And it's all possible because of that very first Christmas. Where the choir of angels had been waiting to burst into song, the first angel announced to the shepherds the birth of the Saviour. The baby in the manger is Christ the Lord. God came to save us from our sins. It's good news of great joy, and it's for all people, not just those who are watching online, but everyone we meet, whether it's our workplace, in the queue, at the supermarket. The Saviour has come, the angels sing. Glory to God for peace to his people. It's the original Christmas number one, the most listened to Christmas song of all time. Or have you heard it recently? Is it the soundtrack to your life? Is it your theme tune? If not, why not? Well, let's join with the angels this Christmas as we sing about the great joy that is Christ born in Bethlehem, the Saviour of the world. So let us stand to sing, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, Glory to the Newborn King.
Hark the Herald
Well, our final reading from the Bible is the visit of the wise men led by the star to Jesus. Matthew chapter 2. The wise men come to worship the baby.
Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Thanks be to God.
Well, our last Christmas carol is O Come All Ye Faithful. As we sing along to this, let's see if we can disturb our neighbours next door. Well, thank you very much for joining us for our online carol service. It's been great that you can join us and sing along at home, knowing that others are enjoying singing along together. This evening, we also have our carol service in Ditchingham at 4 o'clock, a carol service in Denton at 6 o'clock. Our upcoming services will appear on the screen. On Christmas Eve, on the 24th, we have a carol service here in Earsham at 6 p.m. On Christmas Eve at 10 p.m, we have a communion. And at 11:30 p.m, we have a nearly midnight communion at St. Peter's, Heddenham. On Christmas Day, we have our services at Ditchingham at 10 o'clock, Denton Chapel at 10 o'clock, and Arbor Church at 10 o'clock. Well, do keep safe, have a wonderful Christmas, and let me say a final Christmas blessing. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore. Amen. Well, Merry Christmas.
I wish you a Merry Christmas, I wish you a Merry Christmas, I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good tidings I bring to you and your kin. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Three cheers for Chris our Rector, he's our spiritual director, and I don't want to hear objectors, so buy Chris a beer. Good tidings I bring to you and your kin. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. He broadcast a lot on YouTube, providing us with spiritual food. He clearly is a cool dude, so buy Chris a beer. Good tidings I bring to you and your kin. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. He prays for us all on Twitter, evangelically he is no quitter, and we all know that he loves bitter, so buy Chris a beer. Good tidings I bring to you and your kin. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. That's all, folks.